Yo, Boopy, I'm a bit on the headphones. I want to give guys Yanni my version of the prodigal son. Just let guys understand it from, you know, my point of view. Strictly for the website, music with a positive influence, Mwapi Entertainment, www.kmadness.com/Mwapi.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming home.
I'm gonna come back home. I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
Coming home.
I'm gonna come back home.
Standing at the airport, mama starts to cry. Mama, wipe your tears, I'll be back in a year. I'm just flying overseas so I can enter overseas. I'll be back before you know it, ASAP. Doctor before my name, PhD. But that was the last time that he saw she. It's been about 12 years since he's been home. And mama's fast asleep now, she is gone. Baby keeping track of home from the internet. Walks with a swagger, talks with an accent. Hustling, Mickey D's trying to pay the visa. Illegal, alien, can't get a visa. The West, the best, not the place is home. When I sleep, put me 6 feet to rest at home. Yo, they say the grass is always greener on the other side. I say they're full of lies, if you would only see.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming back, mama.
I'm gonna come back home.
I'm coming back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming back, mama.
I'm gonna come back home.
Daddy hooked up with mommy in university, a match made in heaven, together for eternity. Ring on a finger, they moved into a crib. About 9 months later, they needed a crib. Daddy's little girl, daddy was a world. She would smile every time he would throw her in the air. Baby wouldn't cry, cause daddy was there to catch her in his arms, to keep her from harm. But daddy and mommy, there's something going on. Cupid left the building, there's something going wrong. Too many arguments, too many fights. Perfume, odor, meat tents, all night, white tower throne. We can't do this no more. Daddy packs his bags, headed for the door. Throw me in the air just before you go, daddy. Sketch you hit the floor. He turns and says, baby,
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming back, baby.
I'm gonna come back home.
I'm coming back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming back, baby.
I'm gonna come back home.
She slipped, stumbled, fell to her knees. But the church didn't support the sister in need. Instead, they put her on the altar to publicly address, so that they wouldn't look bad, publicly confess. She walked out of church, she's had it with Christ. She's feeling so ashamed, she's had it with life. Boyfriend said it's over, he don't love her no more. But abortion ain't an option, since they already know. A few years passed, her baby about 7. Mommy, when I die, I'm gonna go to heaven. Mommy, flashback, good days on the narrow path. CUBS, the good girl days. Like the prodigal child, I need to go back. Like Mandela for prison, I need to let go. After darkness, the sun will always rise up. She falls to her knees, lifts her hands and says, Lord,
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming home, Jesus.
I'm gonna come back home.
I'm coming home.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm coming home, Jesus.
I'm gonna come back home.
I'm coming home.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back home. I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back home.
God, over one sinner who repents.
Jesus continued,
there was a man who had two sons. The younger one said to his father,
Father, give me my share of the estate.
So he divided his property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all he had, set off for a distant country, and there squandered his wealth in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in that whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country, who sent him to his fields to feed pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. When he came to his senses, he said,
"How many of my father's hired servants have food to spare? And here I am starving to death. I will set out and go back to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.'"
So he got up and went to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. The son said to him,
"Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son."
But the father said to his servants, "Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate, for this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." So they began to celebrate. Meanwhile, the older son was in the field. When he came near the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked him what was going on.
"Your brother has come, and your father has killed the fattened calf because he has him back safe and sound."
The older brother became angry and refused to go in. So his father went out and pleaded with him, but he answered his father,
"Look, all these years I've been slaving for you and never disobeyed your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat so I could celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours who has squandered your property with prostitutes comes home, you kill the fattened calf for him."
"My son," the father said, "you are always with me and everything I have is yours. But we had to celebrate and be glad because this brother of yours was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found."
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.
I'm gonna come back.